So can we start with the basics? Could you sort of introduce us to the story of Marzni's Moms?
Marzni's Moms is about a 9-year-old boy named Milo who has a disagreement with his mother and says some things he doesn't mean, and then discovers that night that she's been kidnapped by Martians, and he goes on an adventure to save his mom and meets a lot of fun characters along the way.
And how do you guys come into the story?
I play Gribble. My mom was abducted, you know, years ago, and I stowed away, and now I'm on Mars as a castaway. And here's the new kid looking for his mom. He runs into me, and then it's the search for the mother, literally. Yeah.
And he comes into the story literally as the sort of renegade Martian who is basically going to help them get past all the security to rescue his mom.
And you are playing a Martian. How do you even begin to try and figure out how to do that?
I just spent some time alone in a room making some strange noises and sounds, and there were a lot of obvious references growing up watching movies about aliens and things. I wanted to kind of do my own version of things that I had seen in the past. Yeah. But
hung out in vortexes up in Sedona.
Yeah, definitely. That's lots of Burning Man. So it was a fun process getting to Martian.
Fantastic. But your character's from a very specific time period as well. We don't recognize a lot of the dialogue that he spits out. How fun was that to get to go back to the 80s?
I grew up then. My formative years were in the 80s. So, and this guy, my character, was abducted when he was like 10. So he hasn't progressed past that time. And all of his, you know, pop culture lingo is from that time. And it was a lot of fun. It was like being a kid again.
The interesting thing about this film is obviously it's not animation per se, it's performance capture. Mm-hmm. So how was that process?
It's basically like doing theater, we feel. I mean, yes, there are cameras on you're wearing a helmet and you have cameras on, you know, the mandibles and you have cameras around the room, but you don't really have anything reminding you very close up front to you that you're shooting a movie. Mm. So you really are just with your fellow actors and you're playing out the scenes and getting to do improv, and you know, it's just very natural. It doesn't feel very invasive.
Very actor friendly.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah.
And do you recognize yourselves in the performances when you finally see the film? Can you see your sort of tics, your movements?
Every single thing that we do. I mean,
they didn't. Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, him specifically. I mean, he's the literal make himself. I mean, for me, it was interesting to see how this was going to translate to the, you know, how my face was going to be her, and I see myself in every moment. So.
Yeah. I found that the looser I was, the better it was, you know, the more alive the computer looked. Yeah. And it's like a giant computer puppet of yourself, which is imbibed with your essence, you know. It's surreal.
Yeah. It's pretty surreal.